the universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path slash direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao slash spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or a train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao slash spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You have the affinity with Buddha. 2. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These three reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him away to
32相82好舍太子为出家学道勤行精进觉悟。 一切种智而谓之佛亦曰佛陀亦曰浮屠皆胡言也华言。 亦之为净觉其所说云人生虽有生死之至于精神则恒不。 灭此生之前则经无量生以积而修习精神清净则成佛。 到天地之外，四维上下更有天地，亦无终极。然皆有成有，拜一乘一拜，谓之一劫。自此天地以前，则有无量劫以美。劫必有诸佛得道出世，教化其数不同。经此劫中有千佛。自出至于释迦以七佛，以其次有弥勒出世，必经三会眼。 说法藏开度众生，由其道者有四等之果，亦曰须陀洹耳。曰斯陀含三曰阿那含四曰阿罗汉至罗汉者，则出入生死去了。明显而不为阿罗汉以上至菩萨者，身见佛性矣。至成道美佛灭度以法相传，有正相末三等纯出之。 年岁远近，亦各不同末法，以后众生愚钝无复佛教而也。 行转二年受箭短经数百千在肩乃至朝身系死，然后有大水大火大风之灾，一切除去之而更立生人又归淳朴。谓之小劫，每一小劫则一佛出世。出天竺中多诸外道，并是水火毒而善诸变幻世家。PG 794。知苦行也是诸邪道，并来鸟恼以乱其心而不能得及佛。道成境皆摧伏，并为弟子。弟子南曰桑门一言习心儿。总曰僧一言行起，女曰比丘尼接替洛须法事类辞家乡。与何居至心修进行起，以自资而防心摄行僧至250。戒尼500戒俗人性平佛法者，男曰优婆塞，女曰优婆夷。皆去沙道淫妄言饮酒是为五戒，释迦在世教化49年，乃至天人鬼并来听法，弟子得道以百千万亿数然。后于居师那城梭罗双树间，以2月15日入班涅盘。涅盘意曰泥环，一言灭度，一言长乐。我进出释迦说法，以人之性时根业各岔，故有大乘小乘之说。至是谢氏弟子大迦叶与阿难等500人追供撰述坠，以文字记载为12部，后数百年有罗汉菩萨相继者论赞明其意，然佛所说我灭度后证法500年，相法1000年，末法3000年，其意如此。推寻典籍，自汉以上中国未传或云久已流，不遭情之。是所以因灭其后张骞时，西域盖文有浮屠之教。哀帝时博士弟子秦景时依存口授浮屠经，中途闻之谓之信也。后汉明帝夜梦惊人，飞行殿庭以问于朝，而复议以佛对帝遣郎中蔡英及秦景使天竺求之，得佛经42章及释迦立像，并与沙门摄摩腾主法兰东海因之来也，以白马赴经因立白马寺于洛城雍门西，以处之其经兼于兰台石室，而又向于清凉台及显杰陵上章第十。楚王因以崇敬佛法闻西域沙门佛经而智者甚众，永平中法兰又一时注经，其余传亦多未能通至桓帝时，有安息国沙门安静经至洛翻译最为通解。灵帝时有月之沙门之称天竺沙门竺佛硕等并翻佛今而知称所译泥环经2卷，学者以为大的本指汉末太守竺容易崇佛法。三国时有西域沙门康森会佛经志，无意之无主孙权甚大敬信，未初中中国人始依佛戒。PG 795。剃发为僧先是西域沙门来此一小品经，首尾乖传位。能通解甘露中有诸事行者往西域至于田国得经90章，晋元康中至夜一之题曰放光般若经太史中有月之沙门主法护西游诸国大的佛经至洛翻译部数甚多佛教东流自此而盛时乐时长山沙门未到安信聪明诵经日至万余言矣。胡森所译为魔法华为晋升指经思10年兴了神物乃正其乖喘宣扬解释时中国纷扰四方隔绝道安乃律门图南游心也欲令玄宗所在留不分遣弟子各区诸方法信义扬州法和入蜀道安与会远之襄阳后至长安福坚胜竟知道安素闻天竺沙门鸠摩罗什私通法门劝兼治之时 译文安令问尧拜至敬尧长弘十二年罗时至长安时道安卒后以二十载以时生凯恨时之来也大易经论道安所证与时所意亦如一出无乖喘出境元西中新封沙门至猛策杖西行到华士城的泥环经及森之律东至高昌一泥环为二十卷后有天竺沙门昙摩罗乘富湖本来至河西举渠蒙逊遣使至高昌取蒙本欲相参宴为孩儿蒙逊破灭姚长弘始十年蒙本使至长安亦为三十卷昙摩罗乘又一金光明等经石胡僧至长安者数十倍为鸠摩罗什才得最优其所意则为魔法华成实论等诸经及昙无忏所意金光明昙摩罗忏亦泥环等经并为大乘之学而时又一时诵律天竺沙门佛陀耶舍一长阿含经及四方律都趋乐沙门昙摩难提一增一阿含经昙摩耶舍一阿毗昙论并为小臣之学其余经论不可胜计自是佛法流通及于四海矣东晋隆安中又有祭兵沙门僧迦提佛一增一阿含经集中阿含经一西中沙门之法领从于田国的华严经三万六PG 796千计至金陵轩亦又有沙门法显自长安由天竺经三十余国虽有经律之处学其书语义而写之还至金陵与天竺禅师拔罗参共便定为僧之律学者传之梁吉成并有外国沙门然所宣亦无大名不可为法门这两五大重佛法于华林园中总集世事经典凡五千四百卷沙门宝唱传经目录又后为时太武帝西征长安矣沙门多为佛律群聚会乱乃照有私进坑沙之焚破佛像长安僧徒一时歼灭自于真正欲闻诏书王逆的免者十一二文臣之事又使修复西平中遣沙门会生时西域采珠经律的170部永平中又有天竺沙门菩提留之大意佛经与罗什相列其地持时的论并为大乘学者所众后千叶佛法不改至周武帝时蜀郡沙门为元松上书称僧徒伪滥武帝出诏一切废会开皇元年高祖普照天下任听出家人令忌口出前营造金像而金师及并周乡周洛州等诸大都邑之处并官写一切经置于寺内而又别写藏于密阁天下之人从风而迷境相景目民间佛经多于六经数十百倍大业时又令沙门至果于东周内道场转诸经目分别条贯以佛所说经为三部一曰大乘二曰小乘三曰杂经其余四后人假托为之者别为一部谓之一经又有菩萨及诸身解奥义赞名佛理者名之为论及戒律并有大小集中三部之别又所学者录其实行事名之为纪凡十一种经举其大数列于此篇又道佛经2329部7414卷